Hey, what's up, guys? It's Louis Beasley, and in this video, we're taking a look at three slim, minimalist wallets made from a company called Kinzd. Now, it may be pronounced Kinzd, but it's spelled K-I-N-Z-D. That being said, if you're tired of that ugly, uncomfortable, bulging wallet, then you should definitely consider one of these slim wallets. A slim wallet would definitely get rid of that uncomfortable bulge, minimize your carry, and also add modern style and convenience to your front or back pocket. That being said, let's jump right into it. Now, the first one on the list is the most simple but practical elastic wallet out of the three. This one took me by surprise because when I first looked at it, it did not look like much at all, and I was questioning how effective it would be. But don't judge a book by its cover. This may not look like much, but it does serve its purpose. On one side, you have a coin slot for storing a few coins. I personally don't carry change in my pocket, so if you're like me, you could utilize that slot for something else, such as a door key. You also have two credit card slots and one money compartment. Now, although there's only two card slots, you can carry a total of 8 to 12 cards in those slots. So this is where that stretchable elastic technology comes in handy. And then last but not least, this wallet also comes with a metal ring for belt or keychain attachment. Now, I personally don't feel comfortable enough to carry my wallet on a keychain or belt, so for me, that feature will probably never be used. However, there are really two things that stand out about this wallet that I really, really liked. First of all, it's elastic. It stretches and returns to its normal form and size. It's common for leather to stretch over a period of time, and then once it stretches outside of its normal form, it's permanent. So I feel like this elastic adds a bit more to the table when it comes to durability and longevity. Number two, you can carry more cards than your average minimalist wallet. This was a big plus for me because I tend to carry quite a few cards. If you have more than one credit card and bank at more than one bank, then you're going to have a little more to carry in terms of cards. So you have that flexibility with this wallet. No pun intended. My only gripe about this wallet, and it is a personal gripe, is the coin slot. Not many people I know personally carry coins, including myself. Even if I did, this slot really isn't big enough. I prefer to keep the coins in my pocket where I could easily access it versus having to squeeze my finger down this tiny pocket on the wallet and try to pull out a coin or two. Just my two cents. Again, no pun intended. The second wallet on this list is probably the slimmest wallet out of the three. In fact, this wallet is so thin, I found myself checking my front pocket often just to make sure it was still there. You don't even really feel this thing in your pocket. So on one side of this wallet, you have three slots for cards, and one of those slots has a clear face, which is ideal for your driver's license or any picture identification card. You also have a thumb opening that allows you to easily slide the front card out of the pocket. On the other side, you have three card slots and two additional slots off to the side that could be used for money, receipts, or things of that nature. Additionally, this wallet is made from Napa genuine leather, which in my experience has been a very durable, reliable, and quality leather. And then last but not least, this wallet also supports RFID blocking. There's a few things I liked about this wallet compared to the last one. First of all, it supports RFID blocking. Not that I'm paranoid about getting my information scanned and stolen, but knowing you have that extra protection there is always a good feeling. Second of all, it's very thin. It doesn't matter if you put this in your front pocket or your back pocket, you're not going to feel it. And then last but not least is the dedicated money and receipt pocket. I tend to toss money and receipts into my wallet after making a purchase, and although that could get me into trouble in terms of keeping things organized, I can easily do that with this wallet compared to my previous slim wallet. The only gripe I have about this wallet is in regards to pulling cards out of the card pockets. Sometimes it can be a challenge, and unfortunately this wallet does not have a release mechanism that raises the card for easier access. The last wallet on the list is what I like to call the money clip wallet. This wallet has a leche pattern design in the leather, which gives it a rugged look and also adds a bit of durability to the leather. On one side you have three card slots and a magnetic money clip for holding a little bit of cash. On the other side, you have another card slot with an ID display window. Now on the side, you have a change pocket for storing change. However, in my case, I would likely use that for additional cash storage or maybe receipt storage. This wallet also supports RFID blocking. However, it does not block the 125 kilohertz frequency. So a little bit of limitation there. That being said, in my opinion, the biggest thing this wallet has going for it is the money clip. The magnet is extremely strong and does a really good job securing your cash. They claim it can securely hold up to 30 bills folded in half. Now, although I have not yet put that to the test, I'm confident that it will. the strength of this magnet on this wallet is no joke. Now, because of the money clip feature, this wallet isn't as thin as the previous wallets. However, it's still thin and small enough to comfortably fit into your front pocket. Again, a tab feature to raise the cards would have been nice on this wallet, but not necessarily a deal breaker. For those of you who prefer money clips over full-size wallets, this would likely be a good choice for you. So, out of these three wallets, which one do I personally prefer? That's a tough question because all three of these offer something that I like. But if I had to choose one, it would probably be number two. That wallet is just unbelievably thin and it just fits my style. Now, which one of these three do you prefer? Let me know down in the comment section. Who knows, maybe I'll give one of these away in my next video. Don't forget to comment and subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. I'll talk to you ladies and you gents in the next video, all right? Sound you later.